Hello everyone, and welcome to the session 2 of Unit 3 Estimation in MachineSoft for the course Estimation and Costing. The course code is 15ME61T. Myself, Mohammad Imran. So, in the last class, we have studied about machining time. So, time, how to find out the machining time required for various operations such as turning, facing, tapping, threading, etc. So in the today's session, we are continuing the various formula for finding the machining time for various operations. So in the today's session, we are discussing the tapping operation. So as you know that the tapping is nothing but the producing the internal threads in the already threaded holes. So if you want to make a thread in a tapping operation, you need a already drilled hole. So on that drilled hole, you want to make the tapping operation. Tapping is nothing but making the internal thread by a special tool known as tap. So time required for tapping is given by length traveled by the tap. So length traveled by the tap, total length that will travel perpendicular to the axis, and pitch into RPM. So divided by pitch of the thread, internal thread, divided into RPM of the tap. So that is given by L plus D by 2. Divided by pitch into RPM. So where length is length of the threaded portion. So how much length is required, length of the thread is required, tap is required, that is considered as L, plus D by 2 is the extra movement of the tap. So that is required, that has to, the tap has to start somewhat from the beginning, not from the exact start point of the thread, but it has to take some extra position before the starting of thread, and it has to move some extra motion after the thread is completed. So for that we are taking a extra clearance in terms of D by 2, where D is the diameter of the tap. So divided by pitch of the thread required, multiplied by RPM of the tap. So that will give the time required for tapping in minutes for one cut. So if you are making more than one cut, then you have to multiply it by several times. So for making one cut, you have to consider both the forward time and the backward time. So the forward cut is the tapping takes place. In the backward cut, there is no the tapping operation takes place. So that is a dummy operation, just like a shaping operation. So we are considering the returning time for tap is half of the time required for tapping. So we are considering the return stroke as half times the forward stroke. That means if the forward stroke, the tapping movement takes 1 minute, and we are considering half minute, that is 30 seconds for returning the tap to the original position for making second cut. So total time required for one cut will be one complete time for forward stroke for threading or for tapping, and the half for return, that will become 3 by 2. Here 3 by 2 is nothing but 1.5 times. Because 1.5 times, 1 time for doing actual operation, 0.5 times in half of time for return. So total time for one cut will become 1.5 times the L plus D by 2 divided by pitch into RPM per minute. So in terms of the parameter, that will be L plus D by 2 divided by pitch into RPM, that is 1.5 times. Why? Because one time, one complete cut requires forward stroke and return stroke. The return stroke, there is no threading or tapping operation takes place. So that has to come, we have to move the tap early, quickly. That is half times the forward stroke we are considering. So the total time will become 1.5. So time plus 1 plus D by L plus D by 2 multiplied by pitch into RPM for one cut. If you have more than one cut, then it has to multiply by how many cuts you are doing. Suppose you have 3 cuts, then 3 into multiplied by all these formula, that gives you the total time for tapping. Next is the milling operation. So as you know that the milling operation is the process of producing flat surfaces, that may be horizontal surfaces or vertical surfaces or angular surfaces, cutting or keyway operation by means of a rotating cutter. Rotating milling cutter, known as milling cutter. So There are two types of steel milling operation. One is cutting and facing. Cutting just like making keyways or grooves or slots. So facing means reducing the depth of the surface. So therefore, time taken for this operation is given by time required for milling equals to length of cut, how much length has to cut, divided by speed into revolution into RPM. So speed into revolution is into RPM, nothing but speed per minute. We know that speed per minute equals to speed per revolution into RPM. Why? Because here this is speed per revolution, this is rotation revolution per minute. RPM is nothing but revolution per minute. So revolution is in the numerator. So this revolution in the revolution and denominator revolution will get cancelled. That will become speed per minute it in the denominator. So that will become speed per minute. So speed per minute equals to speed per revolution into RPM. Instead of that, we can directly write length of cut multiplied by speed per minute, that is n into speed per RPM is expressed in n, speed per revolution is expressed in capital F, F into capital N. So length of cut, this length of cut is not a simple length of cut. You have to add extra movement for this length of cut. Why? Because in always the cutting takes place before you have to start the cutter. Somewhat some extra portion you have to consider before the start of the cutting operation and cutting or facing operation, and after the completion of the cutting you have to move somewhat extra movement of the cutter. So that has to be considered. The initial position for extra initial position is known as approach, and the final extra movement is known as overrun. So length of cut equals to length of job plus table travel. So speed per revolution equals to, so this speed per revolution again is divided by speed per tool, since we are using multiple cutting tool, that the tooth has the milling cutter has multiple cutting tools. The speed per tooth into number of number of teeth on the cutter will give to the speed per revolution. So if you give one feed that will be shared by all the teeth. So in a, you have now to calculate the speed per revolution. We must know the speed of one tooth, so multiplied by number of teeth on that milling cutter will give you the speed per revolution. So RPM n is given by 100s by pi d. So d is the diameter of the cutter, not the workpiece, diameter of the cutter. The total time is given by length of cut per divided by speed per minute into number of cuts required. So it is not not complete the all the operation in one cut. We require more than one cut. So number of cuts we have done, that has to be multiplied by this formula. This will give you the total time. So we are taking cutting operation in milling operations. So cutting is nothing but making grooves or slots. You can see here, this is the cutter here. So initially it has the will not start the cutter from here. So initially you have to take some extra position of the cutter. So that is called as approach. Initial extra position is known as approach. The finished extra position is known as over travel. So the cutter not finish exactly here. So it has to move some extra portion. So this extra portion movement is known as over travel. So while considering the milling operation, we have to consider both approach and over travel, because this is the extra movement. Including the length of the job, we have to add this approach and this over travel. That will give you the total length of the cut. So length of the approach AB. So here approach, if you use the trigonometry here, you can see you will make a right angle triangle here. So this will be expressed as a triangle OBA. So this OA length is exactly half of the diameter of the cutter. So you can see D by 2, OA is D by 2. So this hypotenuse length is D by 2, whereas this OB, you can see this OB is so this length is D by 2. You know that this is exactly the B is exactly in the center. So this portion B2, or this portion is exactly D by 2. If you deduct this depth of the jaw from this radius, you'll get OB. So OB is given by radius of the cutter minus this depth of job, that will give the OB, this distance. So we know that two dimension here. So this hypotenuse is D by 2, whereas this OB is D minus 2 by D. So just we need to find out the length of AB. So So length of AB, this is adjacent side. So we know that the hypotenuse side equals to we want AB here. So using the hypotenuse theorem, we will get AB equals to root of square root of OA square. So OA square minus of OB square. OA is nothing but hypotenuse. So hypotenuse square minus OB square, we have to deduct here. So we know that OA is nothing but D by 2. So if you square that, that will become D by 2 square. OB is D minus 2 minus D square. So if you simplify this, you will get DD minus D square. So root of DD minus D square is length of approach. AB is given. This is the standard formula. In every time you need to take this formula. Approach length is AB equals to DD minus D square, where D is the diameter of the cutter, and small d is the depth of the jaw. So this is the initial position of the cutter. This is the final position of the cutter. So extra moment in the final position is known as world travel, whereas in the initial moment, extra moment is known as approach. So you have found out the approach length, that is DD minus D square. So usually it is taken as pi mm. If you have not mentioned any this dimensions, capital diameter of the cutter or depth of the cutter is not mentioned, then we have so this is length of approach, and wall travel is generally taken as pi mm. So this is approach, the wall travel is generally taken as approximately pi mm. So this formula is for approach. So this is for overrun, usually taken as pi mm for cutting operation. So next is facing option. So in facing option, there are two cases. One is, you can see, when the diameter of the cutter is greater than the width of the vertex. You can see this case, the diameter of the cutter, you can see, it is greater than the width of the vertex. Of the vertex is this much only, whereas the diameter of the cutter is greater than the width of the vertex. That is one case. Another case, the diameter of the cutter is less than the width of the vertex. You can see, this is the width, which is the more than the diameter of the cutter. So two cases will come. In the first case, if the cutter dia D is less than the width of the jaw. So this first case, the cutter dia D is less than the width of the vertex, then approach and over travel is generally so several cuts are required here. Well, you cannot complete the facing operation in one cut. So you have to come here like this, and then for second cut you have to cover the total width of the job. So more than one cut is required for completing one facing operation here. So in case of this case, first case, so in that case only one cut is enough to complete the facing operation. In this case, the approach is generally taken as 0.5d, 0.5 times the diameter of the cutter, and over travel is taken as 0.7d. So when the cutter dia is greater than the width of the jaw, so this one, cutter dia is greater than the width of the jaw, so the over travel EC, you can see the over travel EC, we make a rectangle triangle here, the over travel is nothing but the this length EC. EC equals to, so EC equals to, this is OC minus of OE. So OC is the radius of the cutter, D by 2. Minus of OE, if you deduct OC from OE, you will get EC. So EC equals to OC minus OE. OC minus OE. You know that OC is exactly center, so that is D by 2, radius of the cutter. So we have to take as D by 2. Next, OC minus OE. So this OE is nothing but, again, OE. This is OC is D by 2. You can see this OC is D by 2. Minus of OE. OE is a right angle triangle. So we can get OE by this right angle triangle. In this OA is hypotenuse. So if you want OE, then you have to deduct OA square minus of OA square minus of AE square. OA square minus of AE square, that will give the OE. So D by 2, OA is D by 2 here. OA is D by 2. Again, the radius of the circle here, D by 2 minus of AE. So this AE is nothing but width of the workpiece. You can see this touch here. Okay, exactly width of the workpiece. Width of half of the width of the workpiece, W by 2. So AE is instead of AE, we are writing W by 2 here, width of width divided by 2. So if you translate this, everything, the values, you see here, you will get half, this will be half, you have to take as common. So if you take half common, then you will get D here, minus of this D square, minus of W square. So this is the over travel in case of in the cutter die is greater than width of the workpiece. So this formula will not ask for any this one. So directly, you know, you remember this formula. So if you want over travel, then you have to remember this formula, half into D minus D square by W square. So two main formulas will come here in case of milling operation. So in the cutting operation, the length of approach is DD minus of D square, and the over travel is taken as high enough. So in case of this width of the workpiece is less than the width of the workpiece is greater than the diameter of the cutter, then it is usually taken as approach is taken as 0.5D, over travel is taken as 0.7M. So if the width of the workpiece is less than the diameter of the cutter, then the over travel EC is will get as over travel half into D minus capital D square minus W square, where D is the diameter of the cutter, W is the width of the workpiece. If the cutter die is bigger than the width of the job, then the facing is done in only one operation. So approach is generally taken as over 0.5 times DD. So over travel is, for over travel you need to use this formula. Approach is same for both the cases, 0.5 D. Grinding operation, this is the process of removal of small amount of material by means of abortion. The important methods of grinding are surface grinding and cylindrical grinding. Surface grinding for flat surfaces, cylindrical for cylindrical surfaces or circular surfaces. Surface grinding, it is the process of removal of small amount of materials in the flat surfaces. You can see this is flat surfaces. Time required for surface calculated by using milling formula for cutting operation. It is similar to milling operation. The time required for milling operation is similar to grinding operation. The time required for cylindrical grind per cut equals to length of cut multiplied by here. Length of cut divided multiplied by feet per revolution into RPM, where length of cut equals to length of job plus over travel. So L plus 0.5 cm. Feet per revolution, this feet per revolution is taken as W by 2, where W is the width of the workpiece for rough cut and W by 4 for finish cut. So where W is the width of grinding bit. So the time required for grinding is given by length of cut divided by feet per revolution into RPM. So length of cut is given by length of job plus over travel. So over travel is taken as 0.5 centimeter. So for feet per revolution is generally taken as W by 2, where W is the width of the grinding wheel. For rough cut, W by 4 for finish cut. Shaping operation. In this operation, the cutting is done in one stroke called forward stroke, and the return stroke is a dummy stroke or idle stroke. There is no cutting action takes place during the return stroke. If you consider L equals to length of the job in centimeter, S equals to length of stroke in centimeter, so L plus 5, the total length of cut is L plus 5, L is cutting stroke per minute. So effective speed equals to E equals to S divided by 100 into N meter per minute. So generally effective speed is 3 by 5 times the average speed. The speed is maximum at the middle of the stroke and it is minimum at the beginning of and the end of the stroke. But for calculation purpose, the average cutting speed is C is considered. So you know that during forward stroke, the tool moves in a slower speed, whereas during return strokes, the tool moves in a faster, because we are using fixed return motion mechanism in shaper. So in order to avoid that, we are making an average, we are taking the average cutting speed. The cutting speed is nothing but the distance traveled by the tool in complete one stroke, including forward and return stroke. So it is so the cutting speed is different during forward and return stroke. We are taking average speed, that is 3/5 of average speed. So E equals to 3/5 times the effective speed equals to 3/5 times the speed. E equals to ns by 100. N equals to 60 c by s. So RPM is given by 66 c by s. Not the RPM. This is n is here. Cutting stroke per minute, n is cutting stroke per minute equals to 60 c divided by s, where c is the cutting speed. If f is the feet per stroke in centimeter, then the area served by the tool per stroke equals to f into n plus 5, and the area served equals to f into l plus 5 into n. F into n plus 5, where n is given by 66 by s. F into L plus 5, 60 C, L plus 5 equals to 60 C, yes. So time for shaping operation is given by L plus 5 and B plus 2/5 divided by 60 C. You don't remember all those things. It will not be asked for an examination. You must remember the formula for shaping operation, that will be given by time for shaping operation equals to L plus 5, B plus 2.5, where L is the length of the workpiece and B is the width of the workpiece. 60 CFC is cutting speed, speed is F is speed per stroke in centimeter. That was to remember, nothing but nothing more here. Just you have to remember time for shaping work equals to L plus 5, B plus 2.5, 60 CF. And C is the cutting speed, F is the speed per stroke in centimeter, L is the length of the workpiece, B is the breadth of the workpiece. Thank you for watching this video.